So we were in the demonstration garden in Bronson, and I thought we had pretty much gotten rid of most of these southern sand burr in the past 2 years by digging them up and then putting a pre-emergent herbicide down in the early spring. But what we're going to talk about today at this time of the year, when these sandspur are playing gotcha, we'll use Mother Nature against it. So aside from walking through the area or having your pets go in the area, what are some other ways that you can mechanically collect the sandbur? Well, if you have a riding mower with a bagger or a vacuum, you could track them that way and then dispose of them. But this is also a good time of year to manually remove these burrs. Each one of these burrs contains 1 to 4 seeds. And so the mechanism by which it could stick to your clothing, your pet's fur, tires of your mower, makes it conducive to also sticking to fabric. Let's say if we drag that area that has the sandspur with a piece of cloth and collect the burrs, then burning that fabric or throwing it in the trash, you've actually eliminated 80% of your seed from germinating again next year, because these burrs will lay on the surface of the soil, they'll work their way into the soil, and as I said, each one contains between 1 and 4 seed. So you've eliminated, by disposing of the one burr, maybe up to 4 plants. And that's something that's readily available, pretty easily available for the homeowner. For more information on management of sandspur, or the southern sandbur, or the coastal sandspur, contact your county extension office. You can find them online at Solutions for Your Life, or send me an email at the link below. Thank you for staying tuned today. My name is Barbara Edmonds. I'm with the University of Florida Extension, Levy County.